All right, guys, welcome back to the Travis Jones Show. We are talking about hurdles personal trainers and PTs are going through right now, especially with the online programming and the culture within their members and within their staff. I think it's a really cool topic. Hey, Trav.
Yeah, man. Like, I really love the programming side of things. Like, I actually proposed on Facebook, in 2 months' time, I would have been a personal trainer now for 18 years.
That's cool.
36, and I would have been a personal trainer for half of my life, which is insane. I was like, that's pretty crazy that half of my life on this earth, I've been coaching people to get healthy and fit. And during that time, like, I've had so many, like, I've done heaps of courses and all the rest of it. And, you know, I'm a semi-private coach now, right? Like, so I coach groups. And, you know, you talk to people about how, what's the best way to coach groups and, you know, taking some of their principles. You know, there is no, you know, best way. And I think that's what we have to look at when we're looking in the online program. It's no best way. It's just your way. And from seeing, you know, for us, we have 1,000+ online people doing online right now, you know, 60-something sessions a week across 2 different states, which is pretty crazy. It's looking at what is the best sessions to get community, to get experience, to get results, to get people moving forward. Now, like we've talked about in previous podcasts, and I don't want to go into it too much, different ways of doing online. Yes, you can just deliver them workouts through an app and not do the live workouts, but I really want to talk about the live Zoom-style workouts today. Is that cool?
Yeah, I love it, man. And like, honestly, if anyone's not following your Instagram, some of the workouts you're posting, like, are absolutely insane. And like, this is all stuff like without equipment, right?
Yeah, man. Like, so exactly it, right? So I think the biggest thing is you can get and put people with equipment, but then you're not getting new clients because new clients haven't got enough barbells and kettlebells and dumbbells. And all of a sudden you're putting a hurdle into your growth. And when we talk about marketing, should be marketing still around where your gym is if you have a physical premise. So when your gym opens, you can just bring those people straight into your gym with this online sort of model that we're currently going with. So with this, and we didn't lend our equipment out because it's like 15 different facilities. We've lent out over $100,000 worth of equipment, and we lost a lot of money. Plus the legal implications, if someone gets injured at home, then you aren't under your covered by your insurance. So that's the reason why we didn't start lending equipment out. But in saying that, we have done some great workouts. We have 2 different types of workouts. We do HIIT-based workouts, which is more conditioning. Some are aerobic, some are more anaerobic, so like short, sharp, you know, with recovery, and some are just like aerobic, go, go, go. And we have our tone sessions. And everyone, when I just say the word tone, if you're rolling your eyes, I completely understand and awesome to you. You know, we call them tone workouts because where the market is the tone. Okay, so we do HIIT and tone classes. We have 3 HIIT classes a week, 3 tone classes a week. Our, you know, weighted workouts are essentially full body each time, and our HIIT classes are just getting aerobic going. So, but our tone classes are trying to make people, you know, push to that level so they can either, you know, hold muscle mass or even create muscle mass for a lot of them as well. And we educate our members on this because, again, like, we've got 1,000 people coaching online right now, and they're like, oh, but can I still get results? Like, can I still, you know, move towards a body transformation? Can I still, you know, hold my muscle mass? Like, what about lifting heavy? So we did this whole podcast for our members last week on, you know, different studies from, you know, push-ups versus bench press, you know, strength and size. We're talking about the rep ratio of percentage of 1 RM lifted. So, you know, you can still gain muscle mass of that 30% 1 RM. So it's why we go into more unilateral movements rather than bilateral movements for our lower body. So we're doing like one-legged squats or split squats with your foot elevated, holding a backpack. So if you're holding like a, you know, and I've taught our clients, like, go to Bunnings, get a 10-kilo like sand, wrap that in a Coles bag, tape that up, get 2 of those, put it in a backpack. Now you've got a 20-kilo backpack. If you've got that on your back or you're doing a front rack, split squat, so your left leg, you know, your back foot's up on a bench and you're going down to a Bulgarian split squat. If you're doing that and it's 30% or even like say 25% of your 1 RM, that's saying you can do an 80-kilo split squat. Now, a lot of clients won't be doing that, especially when you're training general population. So if you're hitting around that 30% of that 1 RM and you're going up to 30 reps, then you can hit enough stimulus for them to get some form of hypertrophy, if not at least maintain their lean muscle mass, which is what you want to do for them. So it's like science says yes, okay? And that's what we wanted to help our clients, because obviously with RBT, we're a strength-based gym. We do love lifting heavy. But what we have to look at is you do the best in life with what you have. So life played us a hand, okay, and it's a game of cards. Now we're playing our hand the best we can to get the best results possible. So it's like get your backpack loaded up, do unilateral leg movements, unilateral hamstring movements, pre-fatigue them, use your exercise selection in a way with supersets and giant sets on those tone-based classes. So people, you know, they want to get to, you know, around that 30 reps, if they're doing 30, about 2 to 3 reps from failure. So don't push people to failure. Get about 2 to 3 reps from failure using about that 30% mark. And, you know, hypertrophy doesn't have to be 8 to 12 reps, guys. Like, it really doesn't. So we really had to go above and beyond to educate our members around this. And then we also had to educate them around why are we doing HIIT classes? Like, why Metcons are important for them. I think the biggest reason why we looked at the Metcons, man, is like, one, you want to get the endorphin release from getting that workout in. And so many of us are sitting at home feeling sorry about ourselves. Like, I want to do something to change your state on a physiological level. And that's why we do the HIIT workouts, because I want to improve your mood. I want to improve your day. It shows that your endorphins are going up for the next 12 hours. So if you're doing it in the morning next, your day is good. Like, that's why we do it. We don't do it for, oh, let's burn all the calories and drop fat. Like, cool, yeah. We're doing it because your blood pressure is going to come down. We're doing it because you're going to have a better resting heart rate. But the biggest thing we're doing is doing it for your mental state. Because it is so important to look after people's mental state right now. They're coming on together, doing these HIIT workouts. They finish it, they pumped it out, they crushed it, they're sweating, and they feel good for the next 12 hours. Anything you can do right now that you can make people feel good for the next 12 hours, like, do that. Okay. Like, I think that's such an important thing. But why don't we do just HIIT workouts? Because we want to create our weighted workouts, create enough stimulus so that can hold lean muscle mass, they can maintain or get mean lean muscle mass, depends on what their training age is. Obviously, if you've got like a 500 kilo deadlift, guys, like, yes, you know, the 20 kilo backpack, probably not for you. But I train Gen Pop, and the 20 kilo to 30 kilo backpack really helps for them. So yeah, man, like today, for example, right? Like, so with our tone classes, okay? So it's very tempo-based as well. So when we're looking at this, you know, we might do exercise sequencing. So we might do a pike push-up. So it's like essentially it's like doing a, you know, a push-up, hips in the air, feet on the bench, 3 seconds down, 3 seconds up for 10 to 15 reps. So when you're looking at that, 6 seconds per rep, it's about, you know, when we're looking, it's about, you know, 60 to 70 seconds time under tension. So you're fatiguing, and all of a sudden you're going from that into a backpack, 20 to 30 kilos, strict press. Okay. Again, 1 second up, 4 seconds down, you're going for another 10 to 12 reps. So you're getting that tension, and then you can go, like, you'll start to fatigue, and then you can go straight into a push press. Okay. So now you're going another 10 to 12 reps. And you're going into a push press. So we've got 30 reps, so 10, 10, 10. You go about 2 minutes time under tension. Your shoulders are fatigued because it's shoulder work. And it's like, fantastic, great. You're feeling like you're getting a similar pump, but you're still going to that 2 to 3 reps from failure. You're still using the weight where you're still enjoying the session. You're getting the sweat up. You're doing your tone classes. And then we'll go into essentially like, you know, a leg workout, whether it be like heels elevated squat, or we do some split squats. Like, but today, you know, we use some towels. So we're using equipment they can use at home. So we talked about already, backpack, weighted. I showed them as well, like I taught them how to build a TRX. If anyone wants, it's $20, go to Bunnings and you can build a suspension trainer or your local hardware store. Literally, you know, grabbing a couple of handles for hoses, wrapping it with some tape, using it with some duct tape, getting a tie down strap going together. This is literally why the straps are on next to my desk here. Getting a tie down loop hooked up around either with a door stopper at the top so they can do it off the door, or they can do it around a pull up bar if they want. So now with our tone classes, as we've been in this for like 6-7 weeks now, we've gone from, okay, we're going to start with just tempo. Now we've got tempo plus weight. okay, as far as the backpack. They've got tempo plus weight plus exercise progression with the TRX, okay? So we're still getting a progressive overload, and the guys are building like a $20 TRX. And if they couldn't get the $20 TRX, it's like I showed them it's hard, a little bit harder with the back work, but I showed them get some furniture movers, okay? Mm. So they're like sliders, right? So it's $6 for a pair of furniture movers. So I threw up that app, and I was like, okay, cool. We can do our flies. We can do our lower body work. We can do some lunges. We can overload, create that tension. And that's what we want to do. It's like, guys, like, instead of going, I can't write the best program, so I'm not going to do this, you have to go, I have to do this. How am I going to write the best possible program with the hand that I've been dealt? Okay? So just think you're in a game of cards. You're given a really shitty hand. You just got to play that hand with your poker face as best as you possibly can. And that's all you got to do, guys. And you got to, you know, for us, find a bit of science, help them understand that this is what we're doing. And also it's helping them understand, man, it's like they're enjoying it and it's fun. Yeah. And it's not just jumping up and down with squat jumps all the time, right? You know, HIIT sessions are 3 times a week, but then they're like, okay, there's a difference in their sessions. And, you know, one of the human needs is variety, right? So yes, they, we've given them certainty, okay? Because it's like, we gave them studies, science. This is how you're going to get results still. Don't worry, you got this. Okay. We're giving them significance on the Zoom calls. Like one of our coaches is doing the workout. The other one's like giving shout outs. Okay. So it's like, bang, 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 Susie, Johnny, Jenny, you're killing it. So like, we're giving them significance. You know, I'm like, they're tagging each other on Instagram after the Zooms, like resharing. Everyone's feeling fantastic, right? So we're getting certainty, we're getting significance, connection, right? Because we're like, we're face to face. It's not just shooting out a program, okay? It's connection, love. Like, I remind them, like, it's the best part of my day when I do this. I'm only doing 2 sessions a week, but it's the best part of my week. It's like actually coaching these people. Like, I love it. And, you know, we're giving them variety because it's different. Okay, we're showing them different ways to move. And I think that's one of the crucial things. We're hitting a bunch of these human needs. They're feeling fantastic from the workouts. Yeah, they want to get back into the gym, but we can only control what we can control. And I can't get them back into the gym right now. I can only control the way they do online. So that's why we've done the way we've done it, right? And the HIIT workouts, right? Like, make it fun. Like, yesterday we had a 35-minute running clock workout. Like, and it's like variety. It's like, okay, first 5 minutes, we got this circuit. And then it goes straight into the next 5 minutes. We've got an EMOM of like 10 burpees. Next 5 minutes, like, so it's like for 35 minutes, the clock runs. They get the workout beforehand. I give them an exercise demo every night. So I write the workouts up. It's all programmed through Keystone. I do a video before the workout starts. And I post that the night before. It goes out to all our members. So they can go, okay, cool. This is how it flows. This is how I do the exercises. This is what we're doing. So they can get like, this is what equipment I need tomorrow. I need a bench tomorrow. I need my backpack tomorrow. I need a towel tomorrow. So they understand what's coming up to it. And then all of a sudden, they rock up to the workout. We still demo it as we're going, but they already understand. So it's not too out of left field. And then they crush it. And I think that's one of the best things for us. It's like we're showing up as a community and we're coming together. So that's my thoughts on programming, man. Like, you know, make it fun. You know, give them some certainty. Give them significance. Do understand that yes, you can still get results for them. You know, make your HIIT workouts enjoyable. Don't just send out programs. Okay, don't, like I would say, don't just do that right now. You really want to get those members in because you want to get that connection still. Shout them out on the Zoom classes. You got 2 coaches. One coach is going through it. The other coaches are watching the members, like coaching them through it. Yeah, dude, and get some variety in there. We've like cool towels today. Backpacks tomorrow, suspension trainers, like, you know, and they've got a suspension trainer, a backpack, and some sliders, and it costs them like $30 all up, and they're good to go. And they've got so much variety with all of this. But yeah.
That's brilliant, man. I mean, I guess final thoughts, like, are there any other like major mistakes you're seeing like trainers right now making with this stuff?
I think the biggest thing is, honestly, man, like clear internet connection so you can talk. I've seen some people like videos and like their heads are cut off, or they forget like Zoom like records from like the moment you press record. So press like pause and then press record. So when you upload it later, you should record all your workouts and throw it into your groups for people who miss the live sessions, because so many of our clients are just jumping on after the fact. You need to, you know, make sure you're, you know, giving the shout outs to the people who rock up to the sessions and giving them significance. Hey, shout out to, you know, in the group, Johnny, Jenny, blah, 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 who came through this morning. For the rest of you, I want to see you tonight. So it's you giving them that I'm still keeping you accountable kind of thing. If you have 100 members, guys, if you only have 100 to 200 members, this is super easy to do. Like, make sure your clients are actually training 3 to 4 times a week. They have to be doing this. So it's like making them accountable. We just started a 28-day internal challenge. So I got the idea off like more like Andy Frisella's 75 Hard. But I wanted to create a bit of social proof and go through it like that. So like with this, we if I go onto my online members page, I create a program card and I give them a 5-task checklist. I didn't really want everyone to focus on weight loss right now, more like habit creation. Mm. So with this checklist, what they have to do is they essentially have a program card and it's 28 days straight. So the 28 days straight right now is anyone who's watching this on YouTube or anything like that, it's like, I have to. So they have to do hit their temp calories within 10%. They have to do 20-minute workout minimum a day so they can go for a run or anything like that. If they miss an RBT workout or do an RBT workout that we've pushed out, the 20-minute workouts, they need to hit 8,000 steps a day. They need to meditate for 5 minutes a day and they need to practice great daily gratitude. And if they do those 5 things, they put an X on the day. So there's 28 days of X's. Now, if they get 28 days in a row, that's a 28-day streak. If they get a 28-day streak, they get an RBT Fit T-shirt. Okay. Now, if you miss a day, say you're like day 7 in, and then you're like day 8, you screwed up, you have to go back to day 1. Like it starts at 1. You have to get 28 in a row. So I can see this obviously because we use Keystone for training and nutrition and all the rest of it. So I have all compliance. If you're not using some software where you can check compliance, like you can use Google Sheets and stuff like that. But like for us, that's how we do it. And also, what they have to do is at the bottom of this is they'll essentially tag us. So they'll go on Instagram. You can't really see because it's not going as much. But at the bottom of it, they put their club, RBT Gyms, at like, you know, mention RBT Gyms South, mention RBT Gyms All Up, and essentially insert the coach who is their actual coach. So they're tagging 3 people on Instagram. If they do 28 days of that, then they get a special prize at the end that I haven't signed. But with you guys, all of a sudden, like I'm not coaching really anyone. I'm going to coach at RBT now, but like I've had like about 20 mentions over the last 24 hours. We started this yesterday, but all our coaches getting these tags, and then we want to make it so it's like a bit of a viral thing. So if we have like, you know, 400 people tagging RBT Gyms on Instagram every day for the next 28 days, people are like, what is this thing you're doing? Yeah. So all of a sudden you're creating this like, you know, they're your marketing force as well. But, you know, and you're going to get leads, which is fantastic. And you're giving them, you're solidifying fantastic habits for them. So they're not focusing on weight loss. They're focusing on like meditation. They're focusing on gratitude. They're focusing on actual movement because, you know, motion creates emotion. So they're going to be happier. They're going to get those steps in. They're going to sit at their desk all day. Like they're focusing on the fundamentals that make them a good person. So like with this, this has really brought everyone together running that. And every day, like there's 60 comments in this group. We've got a couple of groups running with people that are just like sort of posting each day. So like we started this yesterday, they'll post their card and every day they'll post their card in the group as well. And it allows us to keep them motivated and pumped up and our coaches can jump in there and go, like, let's do this. That is another, you know, little thing that I started yesterday.
Yeah, mate, absolutely smashing this. And as well as our clients, hey, like we had the Fit Pro Formula coaching call yesterday and our clients are signing up people to their online programs. Really loving it. If you want to get involved in that, just go to fitproformula.com. You get coaching with us. You know, we help you write your ads. If they don't work, we'll just do your ads for you. Like we guarantee success. So go to fitproformula.com, have a chat to one of our team, whether it's me, whether it's Trav, whether it's someone else on the team. We'll see whether this can work for you because we don't take on everybody. If we think it can work for you, yeah, we guarantee you 30 new clients. So go to fitproformula.com to check that out. And yeah, Trav, any final words of wisdom?
Yeah, man, like the call yesterday, I actually messaged you after the call yesterday. Like the call yesterday afternoon on Wednesdays, I do the calls, go through Q&A. And everyone's just loving it. Like everyone's like, crush, like I've got 10 new online sales in the last week, or I've got 7 or like got some guys doing like the Zoom stuff. Some people just doing the program stuff. Some people doing one-on-one online and they're making sales. Like we, it's like, they're like, I've never done anything like this before. And all of a sudden they're getting like 10 sales. One of the girls was like upset because she's like, oh, I only made 6 sales in the last 5 days. I was like, man, like that's like 250 sales a year, like more. It's like 300 sales a year. I was like, are you really upset if you made 300 sales a year? Like, how many sales did you make last year? She's like, 12. I was like, come on. It's like you have to understand, it's like all of a sudden you're showing them, you're unlocking this, like, oh my gosh, this is amazing. Their expectations go from here to here on themselves. Mm. And I had to like reframe and give her perspective. And she's like, oh, okay, I'm actually crushing it. But like with this, it's like, it's great. When you see a light bulb moment go off in a coach's eyes, like, you know, like I said, I've been in this 18 years, man, like in the industry. So that's why we love the coaching side of things as well, because I get to, you know, have a couple of thousand members with RBT and, you know, we get to help coaches train thousands of more people. Yeah. So it's like, it's a bigger impact. And to get them to have a light bulb moment, it's like, wow, I can actually grow my business. I can get out of stress. I can actually start making money. I have more certainty in my future. I think, man, that's the cool thing. So, you know, if anyone is wondering about coaching and they want to, you know, get 5 to 10 clients a week, you know, results, not wherever the word is, but, you know, like
disclaimer of income earnings. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Like some people are actually doing like 5 to 10 a week and they've never marketed or sold before. I was like, you guys are killing that, which is great. But, you know, we guarantee 30 clients over 12 weeks. So I was like, it's a rock solid guarantee there. If anyone wants help, reach out, fitproformula.com. We'll help you out. Other than that, guys, you know, COVID is, you know, it's just an obstacle and you are a person that can overcome it because, you know, the obstacle is the way. Okay, right, guys? So, like, don't be overwhelmed. Don't be anxious. It's all about getting in flow. Remember, guys, if you currently have anxiety about something, it means that your skill level to the current challenge that you're facing is not high enough. So you need to either increase your skill level. So to increase your skill level, how do you do it? Well, you can get a coach, someone who's done what you've done. You can read a book. You can model someone. So that's how you can actually increase your skills really fast, because you're going to have to do this fast right now in COVID to take you out of anxiety, and it shifts you in flow. Right. So if there's an axis, so the X axis, which is like, you know, the upright is challenge, the bottom is skill. If your skill is low and the challenge is high, you're in anxiety. So we need to increase your skill level, put you in flow, and you'll start crushing it. Or you need to reduce the challenge. Very easy way to reduce the challenge, close your business. Right.
That's right.
That's just another way to do it. Like, that's the only way to do it right now. Just like shut up, shop, and give in. But that's not who we are. So if you're listening to this, that's probably not who you are either. So all you got to do is like, how do I increase my skill level right now to take me out of anxiety, fear, frustration, and put me back in flow so I can start crushing it, guys? Because then once you're in flow, you flourish, you crush it, and you start changing more lives.
Hell yeah. All right. Thanks, TJ. And yeah, thanks, guys. Talk to you next week.